I'm Jodi DeJong-Hughes, soil scientist from the University of Minnesota Extension.
And I'm Jared House, administrative manager at the Grant County Soil and Water Conservation District. In September of 2020, we held a Soil Health Expo near Barrett, Minnesota on the Roloffson family farm. We wanted to look at how to use cover crops and reduce our tillage to minimize soil erosion and improve the health and productivity of our soils. This is the third video in the series. In this video, we discuss incorporating cover crops into our conventional and reduced tillage systems. First off, Jodi, could you explain what cover crops are and why they are used?
Sure. A cover crop is vegetation that is planted in addition to or in place of a primary crop. It is invaluable at keeping the soil covered and keeps the soil protected from being eroded. Cover crops are another tool in our toolbox to improve our soil's health and productivity. And farmers are finding many reasons to try cover crops.
Like what?
Well, they can be used to prevent soil erosion, break up soil compaction, suppress and even prevent weed growth, act as a fall or winter forage for livestock, and can build really great soil structure. That's just to name a few.
Okay, for example, if a farmer had a hillside that is susceptible to erosion, they could use a cover crop to help keep that soil in place, or in another situation, use these crops to outcompete and shade out weeds.
Great examples.
Cover crops can also build soil structure. Would you mind elaborating on that? It's something that gets brought up quite a lot.
Sure, soil structure refers to the way the soil particles are grouped together to form little aggregates. And these aggregates vary in size and shape and strength. Soil structure influences how water and air circulate in and through the soil.
Okay, so once we have one or two goals in mind, what next? Do you just go out and buy an off-the-shelf cover crop seed mix and just spread it on the field?
Well, that's an option, but I would suggest picking a cover crop that fits your goals as well as your climate.
Are there resources out there that can simplify seeding choices?
You betcha. University of Minnesota and your local Soil and Water Conservation District can point you in the right direction. Another option would be to use a cover crop tool or calculator. The Midwest Cover Crop Council has put together a cover crop decision tool that can help narrow down choices based on your goals. If you're starting out in cover crops, cereal rye is a very good choice. In Minnesota, we have a short time period in the fall to get cover crops established. Some years, the soil is frozen before we're even done harvesting. Cereal rye likes colder temperatures, has a quick emergence, survives the winter, and is ideal in cooler latitudes. It's hard to go wrong with cereal rye.
We've already touched upon goals and cover crop types, but what are the best methods in seeding a cover crop?
There are a few common methods: aerial application, drilling, or a highboy. To seed a cover crop in the spring or after small grain harvest, the best way to seed your covers is with a drill. This gives good seed-to-soil contact, which will improve the likelihood of success. If you want to seed a cover crop into maturing corn, you'll need a highboy or a plane.
At the field day, I remember John Letterman discussing his operation. I believe he came up with an innovative way to seed his covers into his no-till and strip-till systems.
That's correct. In his no-till fields, he uses a 44-foot bar with tubes that drop his seed in between standing corn rows. At the same time, he top-dresses nitrogen and ammonium sulfate. This is done generally the first part of June when moisture levels are high and he can get away with not incorporating the seed or nitrogen. However, my favorite innovation of John's is his ability to seed cover crops while he's strip-tilling. It's genius.
One other thing I like to do in my strip-till bar is I have set up a separate tube for seeding cover crop behind the containment coulters. So I will get a clean strip. I'll mix fertilizer in my strip and then cover crop seed on the outside. So I'll get a clean strip to plant my crop in the next year. This tube drops here on the outside of the containment coulters. And depending on the soil conditions, it gets mixed in the soil a little bit on the outside there.
A common thing I've noticed with John's operation is that he fertilizes at the same time he plants his cover crop. I would imagine that would save him a pass or two in the field. Cover crops don't necessarily mean extra work. By being innovative, there are ways of killing two birds with one stone. Another innovation is using cover crops when incorporating phosphorus and potassium with a no-till system.
Ed Hagelin is a good example. Ed farms near Appleton, Minnesota, and after wheat harvest, he broadcasts his phosphorus and potassium while drilling in the cover crops. The drill incorporates some of the phosphorus and potassium and makes it available to the root zone, while the rest of the phosphorus and potassium slowly make their way into the soil.
Sounds like another benefit of cover cropping is the ability to transition to a no-till system.
Cover crops have allowed me to transition a little bit towards no-till, which I never ever thought I'd do, and I don't know that I would do without cover crops in the system.
Overall, it seems like there are many good reasons to use cover crops and many possible ways or methods of integrating them into a farm operation. Is there a right or a wrong way to get into cover cropping?
There's no right or wrong way. Farmers have different goals, soils, and climate. There will be challenges with almost any new system a farmer tries. The best advice I can give is start with the low-hanging fruit. For example, planting cover crops before or after a short season crop, like vegetables or small grains. Start small. Try 50 acres in a problem field. Also determine what goal you would like to achieve with the field. Find mentors in your area or experienced crop consultants. And from there, you can experiment and slowly build your knowledge base and confidence.
In the next video of the series, we will listen to farmers who have incorporated reduced tillage and cover crops into their systems.